Hey guys, it's me, Nikki. Today's actually like kind of a little haul video mixed with a pack opening. And like I've said in my past pack openings, I do pre-open the packs and sort them. Just so I don't have to waste time with opening the packs and everything. And I'm also doing kind of a haul video of stuff I got from Christmas since that happened today. So, first off and foremost, the part that you guys probably most care about, the haul of Pokemon cards, we have an Emerging Powers, a Next Destinies, and a Boundaries Crossed. This is my first ever opening of a Boundaries Crossed, by the way, guys. So I hope you guys enjoy it. I've opened a lot of Next Destinies in my life, and I think I've opened a few Emerging Powers. So, like I did last time, since I'm in a good mood and I don't actually use these, I'm giving away the code cards. So, go ahead, write that down. Type that in. Yeah. This is weird for me because I'm recording, but everything is reversed for me, so sorry if I screw up on things, but first off, we've got a Deerling, a Pidove, Rufflet, Petalil, Minchino, which that is a really cute Minchino, a Max Potion, Gatharita, a Ferrothorn, a Gothitelle reverse, which is a rare, which that's pretty cool, a rare reverse, and the rare is Gigalith. Meh. Were there any Ken Tsujimoris in this one? I just thought I'd look. Because I know in one of the packs there's Ken Tsujimori artwork, and he's like my favorite person. No, there's not. Next, we'll go on to the pack of Next Destinies, which has Regigigas on the front. And here's the code card. So get that down anytime now. Yeah. Okay. So, yeah. Oh, yeah, I never show the back of these really that much. There's the back of the Next Destinies cards. There's the back of the Emerging Powers. Anyway, we start off both of these packs so far with grass types, which I think is weird. Anyway, we got a Pansage, a Grimer, Meowth, Blitzel. That's pretty cool. A Fungus. If you guys have heard my other rants, you know why I hate Fungus. A Level Ball. A Starmie. Hippowdon. Hippowdon, whatever the fuck it is. A Scraggy reverse, which is an uncommon. So that's pretty cool. I actually love the reverse on this. I don't know if this is showing it well, but like the little dark symbols. And the rare is Simi Sage. One thing that I think is kind of significant is, I know in the Boundaries Crossed pack, you had both Gatharita and Gothitelle, so that's kind of cool. And in both this and in this one, you have both Pansage and Simi Sage. I don't know. I think that's pretty cool. Next, we've got to my first ever pack. Are you guys excited for this? It's my first ever pack of Origin Power, I mean, Boundaries Crossed, I can't talk. And this is what the back of the code card looks like. It's pretty cool. I actually love Keldeo. They had a thing online where for your Black 2 and White 2 Sea Gear, you could put a Keldeo background. I'm dying. You could put a Keldeo background, and it was pretty cool. So, yeah. And are you guys ready for the code card? So go ahead and just use that code right there and get yourself a pack, because I'm in the giving mood, and it's not just because it's Christmas. Like I've said before, I don't use the TCG online, so yeah. Anyway, for my first ever pack opening, we start this one off, first ever pack opening of Boundaries Crossed, we start this off with an adorable Skitty, Meryl, Oddish, Togepi, which I believe this is the one that's Ken Tsujimori. Yep. Which, I'm sorry if I'm mispronouncing that really badly, but yeah. Ispoink. Charmeleon, which that is a badass. I think I have like a few Charmeleon cards of my own. Tranquil. Mianfu. These cards feel really thick. Warlipede, which is a reverse, and it's actually only an uncommon. I thought it would be a rare, but okay. Oh yeah, Scolipede would be a rare. I guess I'm kind of out of it. And the last card is a Shaymin. Now, though this is not a holo, this is a badass card, because Shaymin is one of my favorite fucking Pokemon. I'm all for cute Pokemon. So yeah, let me see if in here there was any Kensujimori or not. I know that he is my favorite artist for the cards. Nah, it was just that Togepi. That Togepi is my new favorite card ever. And I know Super Duper Tutorials, I believe when she got that card, she liked it too. Okay, so now that we're done with the Pokemon card openings, and we get to some gloomy sounding ass music. I don't know exactly, because like I said, I use Radio Nintendo. We get into some other stuff I have. There's things I have that I can't show you at this moment, but I can at least tell you about it. I got Pokemon Sticker Star... No. Paper Mario Sticker Star. I can't talk. And I got it for a Christmas Eve gift, because that's kind of a tradition in my family. But, yeah, I got Sticker Star. And if you're wondering about the shirt... I know, this is really random, but if you're wondering about the shirt, I got it for free at Warped Tour 2011, and it's supposed to look kind of like the Thriller jacket. I don't know, it's kind of weird looking. I don't like it, but it was festive, because it's... Anyway, I got Sticker Star. I've already beaten the first world. I'm working on world two. I got a Steam wallet. It's $20. But right now I'm having issues getting it to work, so I've actually sent a support message. The next thing I got is Kirby's Dream Collection 20th Anniversary. And if you can see on the box, it comes with the game, which I love the box art. It comes with the CD soundtrack, which has 40-something tracks. I don't know. And it also comes with the Kirby Collection Celebration Book. Which I'll let you look at that a bit. I'll let you look at the artwork. It's pretty awesome. I'm in love with it. On the back you have this Kirby bit, which it's a cavalcade of Kirbys. And there's actually a thing where you're trying to identify which each of these Kirbys on the back here, which games they're from. They could be from any Kirby game ever made. And they actually give you the answers on the inside. But there are 45 total tracks on here, because there are 3 bonus tracks. But it shows you individually which game each of the tracks are from. And there's some really good tracks. Like, there's 3 tracks from Kirby's and the Crystal Shards, because there's at least three tracks from every song, a game, I believe. Nah. I'll strike that. There's at least 1 song from every game. But there's, you know, the Welcome to Dreamland, Green Greens, the first level track. We got the first level track for Kirby's Adventure. You've got stuff for the even Dream Course, which I think is pretty cool that they included that. It's a lot of the main games, but they include a Dream Course, which, if you guys have ever played that, it's kind of like golf, but Kirby style. But there's other stuff in here, too. Like, it shows you every single Kirby game ever made. And the only ones I have never played... And just a random fact for you guys, the only ones I've never played are Kirby's Avalanche, Kirby's Block Ball, Kirby's Star Stacker, Tilt and Tumble, and Mass Attack. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 games out of the multiple games that Kirby has. Inside here it shows you a timeline for all the Kirby games. And it goes in an order. It gives you a little bio about Kirby. And a fun fact, Kirby was originally going to be named Popopo. Popopo. And the first game was actually going to be called Twinkle Popo. So, fun facts of the day, guys. It shows you all of, like, the different friends and characters in Kirby. And it's pretty awesome because, I mean, it includes Choo-Choo and Mago and... Scarfies and Kynes and Chef Kawasaki and Krakko, even Yin Yarn, Dynablade, of course. Got Wispy Woods. You can't go without having Wispy Woods. But then it goes into a detail of all the different games. And it's pretty awesome. The next thing I got, which I have not even opened yet, is The Sims 3 Plus Supernatural. I've been wanting The Sims 3 for a long time, but I haven't had money. So my parents actually bought me The Sims 3 Plus version, because funny story is, I actually got Sims 2 when they had Sims 2 Plus. And that was when you got, like, The Sims 2 and Sims Nightlife. And so this time you get The Sims 3 and Supernatural. So it's pretty awesome. I've actually had it on my Steam wishlist for a while now. But I haven't opened that, and I don't know if I'm going to put it on my Mac or if I'm going to put it on my PC. I'm actually recording this on my Mac. Next thing I got is a whole bunch of lottery cards. Which, I won $3 on this card. Because I got 2 gold bars. Whoa. And I actually bought a card on Saturday, and I got the card. Next, I got this cute orange bow, which I'm going to put it in my hair to show you guys how adorable this thing is, if I can get it out of the packing. Hold on, I will cut here so you guys don't have to look at me struggling to get a damn bow out of a package. Okay, guys, I got the bow off, and I'm going to put it in my hair now. Just to show how adorable it is. I think I'm going to wear it when I go shopping tomorrow. Anyway, enjoy the awesome Pokemon music. I just noticed it was, like, retro Pokemon music, and I'm in love. Other things I've got was I got this hard candy palette, which comes with 2 brushes. You know, those annoying ones that no one likes. And it comes with a set of purples and blacks, shades of purple and a shade of black, you know, like the white to gray, silver and kind of stuff, and it's really cute, and it's got this, like, lacy purple thing, but you can't really see it because of the lighting. Another thing I got is Maybelline Color Show nail polish, and it is in the color Orange Fix 220. And I haven't used it yet, but I've been wanting a better neon orange nail polish, so I'm hoping it works the way it will. Intended to. Another big gift I got is Office for Mac 2011 Home and Student. Because I really needed Word, PowerPoint, and Excel for my Mac. So I now have it. Ignore the random words. But Home and Student, you know, comes with all that, because I don't need Outlook, because I have mail through this, so. And I get 90 days of technical support, which is nice, but I have Geek Squad, so it doesn't matter. Another thing I got is a $25 iTunes gift card, which I can prove to you that it's $25 here. I've already pretty much used it up, because I bought some wonderful music, and I can tell you guys exactly what I bought. If it would like to load, my iPod's kind of lame, and yes, I'm keeping this bow in. Oh my god. Come on. Anyway, I bought all of Cassidy Pope, which I don't know if you'll be able to see. You can kind of see the picture of Cassidy there. And I bought all of her music from The Voice. If I go to my purchases, I have all of Cassidy Pope, as I said, so that has her performances of Torn, Not Over You, Payphone, My Happy Ending, Behind These Hazel Eyes, Over You, Are You Happy Now, Stand, I'm With You, Stupid Boy, Cry, and Steve McQueen. I also bought the entire soundtrack to Pitch Perfect because I finally just watched it Friday, and it was amazing. So I bought the entire soundtrack to that. I bought Gangnam Style, because I needed Gangnam Style, so yes, I bought Gangnam Style. I also bought Bug Hunt, the Noisia remix by Skrillex, because it was in Wreck-It Ralph, and it was amazing, and I love Skrillex anyway. And I also bought, if you guys remember the show The Sing-Off, there was a group on there, the Beelzebubs, and they did a version of Come Sail Away, which is like my current all-time favorite song. Because Styx is amazing, and I love Come Sail Away, especially because of the Yu-Gi-Oh! Abridged version, which if you've heard that version, I love you. You're my new favorite person. But yeah. I also got, thinking of Maybelline, I have the orange Maybelline color tattoo 24-hour thing, so that's pretty exciting. I got a bunch of candy. I also got gift cards to Target, which is $30. A gift card to Kohl's, which is, how much was that? $50. A gift card to JCPenney's, which is $50. And a gift card to Maurice's, which is $30. It also came with a punch card that, you know, if you get, to every $10 you get a punch. And if you get 25, you get a $10 off. And it also came with a 15% off coupon. So, I'm going shopping, and if I turn my camera somewhere over there, if you can see on that chair over there, you'll notice that I have a huge stack of clothes, because I'm a girl, and I'm 18. I get a lot of clothes for Christmas, so, yeah. Yeah, that's pretty much mostly what I got, guys. Oh yeah, I also got Just Dance 4. And that's pretty exciting because I love Just Dance, and the most exciting part of that is the fact that I got to dance to Never Gonna Give You Up, because never gonna give you up, never gonna let you down, never gonna run around and desert you. Yeah, I'm gonna keep you guys from having to listen to my horrible voice there, because I'm sick and my nose is all meh. But I'm going to stop things here, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed this wonderful video-ness. And I will try to make more during break. But I'm trying to save my voice, because I have my audition in February and my ISMA contest in February, the first of many. So I have to save my voice and be able to sing songs. And plus, I'm also practicing already for my April Antics song. If you don't know what, if you've never heard of that from me talking about it, it's our school's talent show, and I'm actually going to try to do it this year, and I'm singing Roger Rabbit, My Sleeping Sirens, because I found a really sick instrumental. So yeah, guys, I'm rambling on. I'm going to end things off here, guys. I love you. I hope you had a wonderful Christmas or whatever December holiday you celebrate, be it Hanukkah, Kwanzaa, whatever the fuck you celebrate. I love you guys, and I hope you had a great time celebrating that holiday, because you deserve it. And I'm going to make more videos soon, guys, so check out all my links down below. Everything is up to date. If it's not, there will be an annotation or something to let you know. You can click in the corner, I believe it is this corner, that has my link to my channel. And on that, you will find my friend Chris Wallace's video. So, go ahead, guys. I love you, and yeah. Bye!